with Ernie Adams. This, you know, was his last draft, and certainly he's been a, you know, huge part of the draft process with the New England Patriots, going all the way to Coach Fairbanks, to the Giants, to Cleveland, to back to New England, and the acquisition of a lot of great players, all the process that goes into drafting, grading players, scouting players, setting up a grading scale, trading, really every single thing that is involved in that. You know, Ernie's had that seat in that role and been a part of all those things in the draft room. So, you know, it's, as always, was, you know, great to work with him, you know, again over the weekend here. So,
is Ernie retiring from all his responsibilities with the team?
Yeah, well, I just want to, give an opportunity here as we close out this draft to, you know, thank Ernie for all he's done and recognize all that he's done. So that's really what it is.
You mentioned how much it meant to you to work with Ernie. For those who wouldn't know, how would you characterize his contributions to the organization over the years? And given this news, is this the time to reveal what pink stripes meant after all these years, if you're familiar with that?
Yeah, no, I'll pass on that one. Yeah, I think Ernie's contributions are, you know, historic. And, you know, again, they traverse several decades and so many different areas. I mean, in every corner of the room, and then some. So, you know, he's literally been involved in every single aspect of the football program at every level that you could possibly be involved in, and you know, has done an outstanding job in all of them. But, you know, not all coaches have the kind of involvement that Ernie's had in the draft process throughout his career, and you know, his knowledge, experience, and you know, decisions and organization, and you know, being part of the process and the way he set it up and taught it to really all the people that have come through here, from Scott to Nick to, you know, all the scouts and so forth. It's really, he's had a big hand in it, again, going back to the foundation of, you know, when it was laid in the middle 70s with, you know, Bucko and Chuck and so forth. So, yeah, I mean, it's on a major level, but at some point he can, you know, talk more about that.